Good morning. It is Thursday and it is now 9:30 a.m. I just woke up and last night I decided that I was going to do something with my life. So I woke up early so I can go on a walk and clear my head. I'm getting ready and I'm going to have breakfast. And I was thinking if I should share the recipe of my oatmeal banana pancakes, and I will share them. It's super healthy. It doesn't take any flour. It's just oatmeal, banana, and an egg, literally. And I add a little bit of cinnamon. I'll let you know. So the plan for today is to go on a walk, to study the most I can because I have a very important test tomorrow. And at night I'm going to try to read 100 more pages of We and the Flame and like 50 pages of the new ebook I'm reading. I'm going to leave the name here because I don't remember the name. And yeah, I'll talk to you guys soon. Okay, so these are the key ingredients: bowl, a banana, one large egg, a little bit of cinnamon, and oatmeal. I always put 5 spoons of oatmeal, and first I smash the banana, then I had the egg and mix it all, and then I had the oatmeal, mix it all, and a tiny spoon of cinnamon. Then we'll just put it on the frying pan. So this is what the mixture looks like. It looks a little bit disgusting, I know, but I swear it tastes heavenly. Well, it is basically very cold outside and it might rain in like 10 minutes or so, but yeah, I'm going on a walk and yeah, I'll talk to you guys when I get home again. Bye. It is now currently 2 p.m. I'm sorry, I went on a walk and then I had lots of things to do when I come home and I got some book mail. I got the Bromance Book Club. It was a giveaway win from Bookish Canadian Girl, Kate. She's amazing. I cannot believe she sent me this one. Thanks so much, Kate. I am really excited to read about this because everyone says it's amazing, it's really fluffy, and I'm feeling I'm going to read this in one sitting because it's really light. And this is the kind of read I'm needing right now. So, update on what I had to do today. I haven't started studying yet. I will in a bit. And I haven't picked up my reads yet because I want to study all afternoon, as I said, because tomorrow I have a very important test and I don't know how I'm going to do this because test is very complex, has lots of things to study, and like test structure is going to be lots of multiple choices questions and then a question for you to write and develop a lot. So I'm really curious about what the theme will be for that question because last year it was about Spanish Republic or something like that. I'm not sure. And the year before it was Spanish in the 20th century. So I'm not sure what the theme will be this year. So I wanted to update you guys. I got some books these past few days. I might do a little book haul soon. But I am also, I forgot to tell you that I am also reading From Blood and Ash by Jennifer Lemon Trout. And I haven't gone much into the book yet because as I said, I've been studying a lot, so I haven't really located my attention into the book, but I've read 150 pages so far, and it's fucking amazing. It's a lot of spicy and
there's a lot of smut already, and you can see that the relationship between Oak and Poppy is going to evolve in a very hot way, and I'm here for it. I cannot wait. And I'm reading We Hunt the Flame, and this book is very confusing, and it started really slow paced, so I was struggling into getting into it. But now, yesterday, I read 100 pages, and I'm on page 200 right now, and now it's getting to good part, because the main character, the huntress, is meeting the assassin, who is the son of the sultan, and they supposedly are to kill each other because the silver witch is a threat to the kingdom, and she made a deal with the sultan, so she could retrieve magic which was lost for a very long time, and the deal was she would do it if the assassin, that is Nazir, the king, the sultan's son, god, my stuttering, if he killed Huntress. It is very, very confusing at first. I didn't understand shit I was reading. But now I'm getting into it. I can see something building up, even though I'm mad at him because he killed her best friend. And her best friend was with her. And he proposed to her. And he killed him. Well. So, I won't restrain you anymore. And I will do what I have to do. I'm going to edit some photos to post on Bookstagram, and I'll talk to you guys as soon as I can. Good morning, friends. It is currently the next day, Friday, the 29th. I am feeling great because I had a 10-hour sleep and I woke up at noon and I am currently preparing lunch. I have to leave in 1 hour for the test and I am super nervous, but could be worse. I have been feeling a bit of pain in my body, like my arms are heavy and I can't really move them. I don't know, maybe I'm just needing more rest. Anyways, yesterday I managed to read 85 more pages of We Hunt the Flame, and I discovered that the Silver Witch is in fact one of the six sisters that were legends in Aroia. And basically, they were legends because they were supposedly dead, and she's not dead. She's the sixth sister, and she turned bad. I mean, it's really complicated, and I'm seeing relationship between Zafira and Nazir to grow, and I cannot wait. I am here for it, but it's starting to go slow-paced again, and it's taking me ages to read. But hopefully I can finish it today, because I only have tests in like 15th of February, so yes, I can read a bit more. So that's my little update for now. I'll talk to you guys. Okay, I need to talk about this. What the fork? Basically, Nasir and Safira went to the Harsh. That is a place abandoned and ruined by magic, and there are some creatures living there, and one of the creatures is called a Safi, and I imagine it to be like a human person with like lion ears and with two earrings, you know, those round earrings. I can't say the name actually, but yeah, and they look really badass, and they have those tiger eyes, lion eyes. God, they must be really cool. And this book is giving me lots of Aladdin vibes, because everything happens in Aroia, that is like a kingdom full of mysteries and magic, even though the magic is covered and people are trying to get it back. But now that they know the Silver Witch is actually one of the six sisters, and magic can't be erased without using magic, they know they have a chance to get magic back. And chapter 53, what the fuck? Literally, Zafira woke up and she wanted to take a bath, and she went to the nearest waterfall, and Nasir was having a bath there. I mean, and she was inspecting his body, and then he looked at her and he smirked, and then they were discussing why she was spying on him, and she wasn't spying on him, she just wanted to have a bath, but he thought of it first, and then he said, ah, you shouldn't be here because that gives the wrong impression to men. And then there's this quote that I'm going to read to you as soon as I get there. There you go. She quotes three rules from Aroia. And the rules state, never sneak up on an assassin unless you want to get caught. Never wander near a murderer unless you want to be next. And the last one, never watch a man undress unless you want him to get the wrong impression. She didn't watch him undress, but she saw him naked. And when he asks her if she saw him naked, she says not, but she does. And she appreciates every little glimpse of his body, and she noticed some blade marks on his back. And she skipped wondering, why did he have those blade marks on his back? And my theory is that the Sultan used to beat him when he was a child, and those were scars. And yeah, but they kind of sparkle in the light. I don't know why, and that's why I think from the beginning of the book that both Zafira and Nasir have magic in them, but they don't know how to control it or to use it. It hasn't been said yet, but I know definitely it will happen. I'll talk to you guys once I have another update. Okay, you guys, you need to listen to this. He had been so sure of so much, but now he wasn't certain of anything anymore. He paused and met her eyes. If a poet were to describe them, he would say to look into her eyes was to see the sea's first glimpse of the sun, drinking its reflection with endless ripples, or something like that. He's in love with her. Guys, this book is going to kill me. Just see this. Basically, Nazir showed Zafira that he has a tattoo on his arm, and it's written in Sifatic, and it means I once loved. Just read this. She had heard those words elsewhere, but they seemed forever ago now. He was a mess of scars like the sky was a mess of stars, from the one stretched down his face to the craters on his back to the ink on his arm. For that was what scars were, weren't they? A remembrance of moments dark. There was more to the prince than she'd first thought. I'm going to die! The biggest plot twist. What? I think I might cry. And I'm speechless. What the fuck? I need a moment or two. So, I finished this as I planned to. Yay for me. But now I'm pissed. This book turned out even better than I expected. I don't have the second book, but I'm ordering it right away because I can't even. Guys, I'm going to explain this. There were some hot scenes here. Yay, loved them. Two big plot twists. Altair is a Safin, and he's Nazir's brother, and the Lion of the Night, which is the one who got all the magic for himself and took the magic from the sisters' hearts, is Altair's father. And the Silver Witch is Nazir's mother. What the fuck? This book was all about a quest to retrieve the Jawarat. That was the book to retrieve the magic, and Zafira bound herself to the book. The book perished, and the magic is inside of her. Holy fuck! When I was like in 100 pages in this book, this was a solid 3.5. stars for me. It is a 5-star read for me now. I was not expecting that. It was so good. I want to read it again. Guys, do yourself a favor and buy this book and read it, please. We Hunt the Flame by Afsa Tasir. I don't even have a good reaction to this because it was so good. It's like, if you like fantasy and animist lovers, this is an animist lovers trope. This book is for you. Even I will write a huge review of this because I have lots to rant about, but as this vlog is beginning to be a very big vlog, I am going to close it now with me being super hyped for this book and ordering the next as soon as I can. So good. I just searched some fan art on the internet and the characters are exactly as I pictured them. I think I might sleep with this book tonight. It was so good. Okay, I won't bother you anymore. 5-star read, do it. Read it. Fucking amazing, fucking spectacular, remarkably good. Go buy it. Okay, this is me saying goodbye. It is almost 1 a.m. In Portugal, so I should probably go to sleep, even though I am too awake and I cannot sleep. I'm probably gonna watch a movie or something. But yeah, I see you guys next week, and I cannot wait for you guys to read this book, but because damn, it was good. All right, see you then. Bye bye.